Hello, welcome back to Numbers. This time it's chapters 26 through 30. Let's say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for another beautiful day in your beautiful earth. And thank you for allowing us to wake up today. And thank you for what you did for us in the past, present, and what you will do for us in the future. Excuse me. Sorry for the sins I have sinned. I have forgiven the people who sinned against me. Thank you for keeping me on the right path in life and away from the wrong path. And please bless Vicky, who is also known as the Night Owl. Today is her birthday. Please bless her and some happiness. And please look after the people in Europe who was killed by the flood or was affected by the flood. And help Dan through his mental and physical issues he's having right now. And help the Smithy family from the UK. In the name of Jesus, amen. It's already on NLT.
Chapter 26, the second registration of Israel's troops. After the plague had ended, the Lord said to Moses and to Eleazar, son of Aaron the priest, from the whole community of Israel, record the names of all the warriors by their families. List all the men 20 years old or older who are able to go to war. So there on the plains of Moab beside the Jordan River, across from Jericho, Moses and Eleazar the priest issued these instructions to the leaders of Israel. List all the men of Israel 20 years old and older, just as the Lord commanded Moses. This is the record of all the descendants of Israel who came out of Egypt. The tribe of Reuben. These were the clans descended from the sons of Reuben, Jacob's oldest son. The Hanachite clan, named after their ancestor Hanok. The Paluite clan, named after their ancestor Palu. The Hezronite clan, named after their ancestor Hezron. The Carmite clan, named after their ancestor Carmi. These were the clans of Reuben. Their registered troops numbered 43,730. Palu was the ancestor of Eliab, and Eliab was the father of Nemuel, Dathan, and Abiram. This Dathan and Abiram are the same community leaders who conspired with Korah against Moses and Aaron, rebelling against the Lord. But the earth opened up its mouth and swallowed them with Korah, and fire devoured 250 of their followers. This served as a warning to the entire nation of Israel. However, the sons of Korah did not die that day. The tribe of Simeon. These were the clans descended from the sons of Simeon. The Jemuelite clan, named after their ancestor Jemuel. The Jamanite clan, named after their ancestor Jamin. The Jachonite clan, named after their ancestor Jachin. The Zoharite clan, named after their ancestor Zohar. The Shawlite clan, named after their ancestor Shawl. These were the clans of Simeon. Their registered troops numbered 22,200. The tribe of Gad. These were the clans descended from the sons of Gad. The Zephonite clan, named after their ancestor Zephon. The Haggite clan, named after their ancestor Haggai. The Shunite clan, named after their ancestor Shunai. The Osnite clan, named after their ancestor Osni. The Arite clan, named after their ancestor Arai. The Aradite clan, named after their ancestor Aradai. The Aralite clan, named after their ancestor, Arali. These were the clans of Gad. Their registered troops numbered 40,500. The tribe of Judah. Judah had two sons, and Onan, who had died in the land of Canaan. These were the clans descended from Judah's surviving sons. The Shelonite clan, named after their ancestor, Shelah. The Perizzite clan, named after their ancestor, Perez. The Zerahite clan, named after their ancestor Zerah. These were the subclans descended from the Perizzites. The Hezronites, named after their ancestor Hezron. The Hamulites, named after their ancestor Hamul. These were the clans of Judah. Their registered troops numbered 76,500. The tribe of Issachar. These were the clans descended from the sons of Issachar. The Tolaite clan, named after their ancestor Tola. The Puite clan, named after their ancestor Pua. The Jashubite clan, named after their ancestor Jashub. The Shimronite clan, named after their ancestor Shimron. These were the clans of Issachar. Their registered troops numbered 64,300. The tribe of Zebulun. These were the clans descended from the sons of Zebulun. The Seredite clan, named after their ancestor Sered. The Elonite clan, named after their ancestor Elon. The Jalealite clan, named after their ancestor Jaleel. These were the clans of Zebulun. Their registered troops numbered 60,500. The tribe of Manasseh. Two clans were descended from Joseph through Manasseh and Ephraim. These were the clans descended from Manasseh. The Makarite clan, named after their ancestor Maker. The Gileadite clan, named after their ancestor Gilead, Maker's son. These were the subclans descended from the Gileadites. The Izarites, named after their ancestor Izer. The Helakites, named after their ancestor Helak. The Azraelites, named after their ancestor Azrael. The Shechemites, named after their ancestor Shechem. The Shemitaites, named after their ancestor Shemitah. The Heferites, named after their ancestor Hefer. One of Hefer's descendants, Zelophehad, had no sons, but his daughters' names were Mala, Noah, Hogla, Milcah, and Tirzah. These were the clans of Manasseh. Their registered troops numbered 52,700. The tribe of Ephraim. These were the clans descended from the sons of Ephraim. The Shuthelahite clan, named after their ancestor Shuthelah. The Becherite clan, named after their ancestor Becher. The Tahanite clan, named after their ancestor Tahan. This was the subclan descended from the Shuthelahites. The Aaronites, named after their ancestor Aaron. These were the clans of Ephraim. Their registered troops numbered 32,500. These clans of Manasseh and Ephraim were all descendants of Joseph. The tribe of Benjamin. These were the clans descended from the sons of Benjamin. The Belaite clan, named after their ancestor Bela. The Ashbelite clan, named after their ancestor Ashbel. The Ahiramite clan, named after their ancestor Ahiram. The Shufamite clan, named after their ancestor Shufam. The Hufamite clan, named after their ancestor Hufam. These were the subclans descended from the Belaites. The Ardites, named after their ancestor Ard. The Naamites, named after their ancestor Naaman. These were the clans of Benjamin. Their registered troops numbered 45,600. The tribe of Dan. These were the clans descended from the sons of Dan. The Shuhamite clan, named after their ancestor Shuham. These were the Shuhamite clans of Dan. Their registered troops numbered 64,400. The tribe of Asher. These were the clans descended from the sons of Asher. The Imnite clan, named after their ancestor Imnah. The Ishvite clan, named after their ancestor Ishvi. The Barite clan, named after their ancestor Beriah. These were the subclans descended from the Barites. The Heberites, named after their ancestor Heber. The Melchielites, named after their ancestor Melchiel. Asher also had a daughter named Sirah. These were the clans of Asher. Their registered troops numbered 53,400. The tribe of Naphtali. These were the clans descended from the sons of Naphtali. The Jazeelite clan, named after their ancestor Jazeel. The Gunite clan, named after their ancestor Gunai. The Jezerite clan, named after their ancestor Jezer. The Shilamite clan, named after their ancestor Shilam. These were the clans of Naphtali. Their registered troops numbered 45,400. Wow. Results of the registration. In summary, the registered troops of all Israel numbered 601,730. Then the Lord said to Moses, divide the land among the tribes and distribute the grants of land in proportion to the tribes' populations, as indicated by the number of names on the list. Give the larger tribes more land and the smaller tribes less land, each group receiving a grant in proportion to the size of its population. But you must assign the land by lot and give land to each ancestral tribe according to the number of names on the list. Each grant of land must be assigned by lot among the larger and smaller tribal groups. The tribe of Levi. This is the record of the Levites who were counted according to their clans. The Gershonite clan, named after their ancestor Gershon. The Kohathite clan, named after their ancestor Kohath. The Merarite clan, named after their ancestor Merari. The Libnites, the Hebronites, the Malites, the Mushites, and the Korahites were all subclans of the Levites. Now Kohath was the ancestor of Amram, and Amram's wife was named Jochebed. She was also a descendant of Levi, born among the Levites in the land of Egypt. Amram and Jochebed became the parents of Aaron, Moses, and their sister Miriam. To Aaron were born Nadab, Abihu, Eleazar, and Ithamar. But Nadab and Abihu died when they burned before the Lord the wrong kind of fire, different than he had commanded. The men from the Levite clans who were 1 month old or older numbered 23,000. But the Levites were not included in the registration of the rest of the people of Israel because they were not given an allotment of land when it was divided among the Israelites. So these are the results of the registration of the people of Israel as conducted by Moses and Eleazar the priest on the plains of Moab beside the Jordan River across from Jericho. Not one person on this list had been among those listed in the previous registration taken by Moses and Aaron in the wilderness of Sinai. For the Lord had said of them, they will all die in the wilderness. Not one of them survived except Caleb, son of Jephunneh, and Joshua, son of Nun.
Wow.
Chapter 27. The Daughters of Zelophehad. One day a petition was presented by the daughters of Zelophehad, Mahlah, Noah, Hoglah, Milcah, and Tirzah. Their father, Zelophehad, was a descendant of Hepher, son of Gilead, son of Maker, son of Manasseh, son of Joseph. These women stood before Moses, Eleazar the priest, the tribal leaders, and the entire community at the entrance of the tabernacle. Our father died in the wilderness, they said. He was not among Korah's followers who rebelled against the Lord. He died because of his own sin. But he had no sons. Why should the name of our father disappear from his clan just because he had no sons? Give us property along with the rest of our relatives. So Moses brought their case before the Lord. And the Lord replied to Moses, the claim of the daughters of Zelophehad is legitimate. You must give them a grant of land along with their father's relatives. Assign them the property that would have been given to their father. And give the following instructions to the people of Israel. If a man dies and has no son, then give his inheritance to his daughters. And if he has no daughter either, transfer his inheritance to his brothers. If he has no brothers, give his inheritance to his father's brothers. But if his father has no brothers, give his inheritance to the nearest relative in his clan. This is a legal requirement for the people of Israel, just as the Lord commanded Moses. Joshua chosen to lead Israel. One day the Lord said to Moses, climb one of the mountains east of the river and look out over the land I have given the people of Israel. After you have seen it, you will die like your brother Aaron. For you both rebelled against my instructions in the wilderness of Zin. When the people of Israel rebelled, you failed to demonstrate my holiness to them at the waters. These are the waters of Meribah at Kadesh in the wilderness of Zin. Then Moses said to the Lord, O Lord, you are the God who gives breath to all creatures. Please appoint a new man as leader for the community. Give them someone who will guide them wherever they go and will lead them into battle so the community of the Lord will not be like sheep without a shepherd. The Lord replied, take Joshua, son of Nun, who has the spirit in him, and lay your hands on him. Present him to Eleazar the priest before the whole community and publicly commission him to lead the people. Transfer some of your authority to him, so the whole community of Israel will obey him. When direction from the Lord is needed, Joshua will stand before Eleazar the priest, who will use the Urim, one of the sacred lots cast before the Lord, to determine his will. This is how Joshua and the rest of the community of Israel will determine everything they should do. So Moses did as the Lord commanded. He presented Joshua to Eleazar the priest and the whole community. Moses laid his hands on him and commissioned him to lead the people, just as the Lord had commanded through Moses. Chapter 28, The Daily Offerings. The Lord said to Moses, "Give these instructions to the people of Israel. The offerings you present as special gifts are a pleasing aroma to me. They are my food. See to it that they are brought at the appointed times and offered according to my instructions. Say to the people, this is the special gift you must present to the Lord as your daily burnt offering. You must offer 2 1-year-old male lambs with no defects. Sacrifice one lamb in the morning and the other in the evening. With each lamb, you must offer a grain offering of 2 quarts of choice flour mixed with 1 quart of pure oil of pressed olives. This is the regular burnt offering instituted at Mount Sinai as a special gift, a pleasing aroma to the Lord. Along with it, you must present the proper liquid offering of 1 quart of alcoholic drink with each lamb, poured out in the holy place as an offering to the Lord. Offer the second lamb in the evening with the same grain offering and liquid offering. It, too, is a special gift, a pleasing aroma to the Lord. The Sabbath Offerings. On the Sabbath day, sacrifice 2 1-year-old male lambs with no defects. They must be accompanied by a grain offering of 4 quarts of choice flour moistened with olive oil and a liquid offering. This is the burnt offering to be presented each Sabbath day in addition to the regular burnt offering and its accompanying liquid offering. The Monthly Offerings. On the first day of each month, present an extra burnt offering to the Lord of 2 young bulls, 1 ram, and 7 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. These must be accompanied by grain offerings of choice flour moistened with olive oil, 6 quarts with each bull, 4 quarts with the ram, and 2 quarts with each lamb. This burnt offering will be a special gift, a pleasing aroma to the Lord. You must also present a liquid offering with each sacrifice, 2 quarts of wine for each bull, 1/3 of a gallon for the ram, and 1 quart for each lamb. Present this monthly burnt offering on the first day of each month throughout the year. On the first day of each month, you must also offer 1 male goat for a sin offering to the Lord. This is in addition to the regular burnt offering and its accompanying liquid offering. Offerings for the Passover. On the 14th day of the first month, you must celebrate the Lord's Passover. On the following day, the 15th day of the month, a joyous 7-day festival will begin, but no bread made with yeast may be eaten. The first day of the festival will be an official day for holy assembly, and no ordinary work may be done on that day. As a special gift, you must present a burnt offering to the Lord, 2 young bulls, 1 ram, and 7 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. These will be accompanied by grain offerings of choice flour moistened with olive oil, 6 quarts with each bull, 4 quarts with the ram, and 2 quarts with each of the 7 lambs. You must also offer a male goat as a sin offering to purify yourselves and make yourselves right with the Lord. Present these offerings in addition to your regular morning burnt offering. On each of the 7 days of the festival, This is how you must prepare the food offering that is presented as a special gift, a pleasing aroma to the Lord. These will be offered in addition to the regular burnt offerings and liquid offerings. The 7th day of the festival will be another official day for holy assembly, and no ordinary work may be done on that day. Offerings for the Festival of Harvest. At the Festival of Harvest, when you present the first of your new grain to the Lord, you must call an official day for holy assembly, and you may do no ordinary work on that day. Present a special burnt offering on that day as a pleasing aroma to the Lord. It will consist of 2 young bulls, 1 ram, and 7 1-year-old male lambs. These will be accompanied by grain offerings of choice flour moistened with olive oil, 6 quarts with each bull, 4 quarts with the ram, and 2 quarts with each of the 7 lambs. Also offer 1 male goat to purify yourselves and make yourselves right with the Lord. Prepare these special burnt offerings along with their liquid offerings in addition to the regular burnt offering and its accompanying grain offering. Be sure that all the animals you sacrifice have no defects. Chapter 29, Offerings for the Festival of Trumpets. Celebrate the Festival of Trumpets each year on the first day of the appointed month in early autumn. You must call an official day for holy assembly, and you may do no ordinary work. On that day, you must present a burnt offering as a pleasing aroma to the Lord. It will consist of one young bull, one ram, and 7 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. These must be accompanied by grain offerings of choice flour moistened with olive oil, 6 quarts with the bull, 4 quarts with the ram, and 2 quarts with each of the 7 lambs. In addition, you must sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering to purify yourselves and make yourselves right with the Lord. These special sacrifices are in addition to your regular monthly and daily burnt offerings, and they must be given with their prescribed grain offerings and liquid offerings. These offerings are given as a special gift to the Lord, a pleasing aroma to Him. Offerings for the Day of Atonement. 10 days later, on the 10th day of the same month, you must call another holy assembly. On that day, the Day of Atonement, the people must go without food and must do no ordinary work. You must present a burnt offering as a pleasing aroma to the Lord. It will consist of 1 young bull, 1 ram, and 7 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. These offerings must be accompanied by the prescribed grain offerings of choice flour moistened with olive oil, 6 quarts of choice flour with the bull, 4 quarts of choice flour with the ram, and 2 quarts of choice flour with each of the 7 lambs. You must also sacrifice 1 male goat for a sin offering. This is in addition to the sin offering of atonement and the regular daily burnt offering with its grain offering and their accompanying liquid offerings. Offerings for the Festival of Shelters. 5 days later, on the 15th day of the same month, you must call another holy assembly of all the people, and you may do no ordinary work on that day. It is the beginning of the Festival of Shelters, a 7-day festival to the Lord. On the first day of the festival, you must present a burnt offering as a special gift, a pleasing aroma to the Lord. It will consist of 13 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings must be accompanied by a grain offering of choice flour moistened with olive oil. 6 quarts for each of the 13 bulls, 4 quarts for each of the 2 rams, and 2 quarts for each of the 14 lambs. You must also sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering, in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the second day of this 7-day festival, sacrifice 12 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings of bulls, rams, and lambs must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the third day of the festival, sacrifice 11 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings of bulls, rams, and lambs must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering, in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the fourth day of the festival, sacrifice 10 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings of bulls, rams, and lambs must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering, in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the fifth day of the festival, sacrifice 9 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings of bulls, rams, and lambs must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the sixth day of the festival, sacrifice 8 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 1-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings of bulls, rams, and lambs must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice a male goat as a sin offering in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the seventh day of the festival, sacrifice 7 young bulls, 2 rams, and 14 one-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings of bulls, rams, and lambs must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice 1 male goat as a sin offering in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. On the eighth day of the festival, proclaim another holy day. You must do no ordinary work on that day. You must present a burnt offering as a special gift, a pleasing aroma to the Lord. It will consist of 1 young bull, 1 ram, and 7 one-year-old male lambs, all with no defects. Each of these offerings must be accompanied by its prescribed grain offering and liquid offering. You must also sacrifice 1 male goat as a sin offering, in addition to the regular burnt offering with its accompanying grain offering and liquid offering. You must present these offerings to the Lord at your annual festivals. These are in addition to the sacrifices and offerings you present in connection with vows or as voluntary offerings, burnt offerings, grain offerings, liquid offerings, or peace offerings. So Moses gave all of these instructions to the people of Israel as the Lord had commanded him.
Last one, guys.
Chapter 30, Laws Concerning Vows. Then Moses summoned the leaders of the tribes of Israel and told them, "This is what the Lord has commanded. A man who makes a vow to the Lord or makes a pledge under oath must never break it. He must do exactly what he said he would do. If a young woman makes a vow to the Lord or a pledge under oath while she is still living at her father's home, and her father hears of the vow or pledge and does not object to it, then all her vows and pledges will stand. But if her father refuses to let her fulfill the vow or pledge on the day he hears of it, then all her vows and pledges will become invalid. The Lord will forgive her because her father would not let her fulfill them. Now suppose a young woman makes a vow or binds herself with an impulsive pledge and later marries. If her husband learns of her vow or pledge and does not object on the day he hears of it, her vows and pledges will stand. But if her husband refuses to accept her vow or impulsive pledge on the day he hears of it, he nullifies her commitments, and the Lord will forgive her. If, however, a woman is a widow or is divorced, she must fulfill all her vows and pledges. But suppose a woman is married and living in her husband's home when she makes a vow or binds herself with a pledge. If her husband hears of it and does not object to it, her vow or pledge will stand. But if her husband refuses to accept it on the day he hears of it, her vow or pledge will be nullified and the Lord will forgive her. So her husband may either confirm or nullify any vows or pledges she makes to deny herself. But if he does not object on the day he hears of it, then he is agreeing to all her vows and pledges. If he waits more than a day and then tries to nullify a vow or pledge, he will be punished for her guilt. These are the regulations the Lord gave Moses concerning relationships between a man and his wife and between a father and a young daughter who still lives at home.
And that is it. I hope you gained something from this. Don't forget, God loves you. Love, don't judge. Peace out.